night started. Oh, to get us in the mood, Mr. Official Tree, is your choir ready?
Certainly, Miss Plateau. And if you're waiting on me, you're backing up.
Oh, boys and girls, you know our choir director, Mr. R.T. Official Tree.
Okay, choir, let's see if we can whip this puppy into tip-top shape.
A staple of stage and film, Gloria LeMay. kids, listen up. This test is going to take about 3 hours to complete, so make sure that y'all go to the bathroom before we start. Because when I get this thing started, you're not going to be able to leave the room, and it's going to take 3 hours. Well, hello, Miss Leto. What are you doing here?
Hello, Coach. Students, you all know Coach Christmas Saver. We're doing our dress rehearsal for the annual Christmas Star Competition. You know, it's been a highlight of the Christmas season forever around here.
Well, I don't know all about all that, but I know that these students here have got to take the HHSUVBR 549 achievement test before the Christmas break starts. And since today is the last day of classes, that would mean we gotta take the test today.
Wait, I have the auditorium booked all semester. It's crucial that we do this rehearsal today. The show is tomorrow.
Well, I'll tell you what's crucial. It's the HHMVP 8675309 achievement test. I'd say that takes priority well over some silly Christmas play.
Play? It is not a play. It is the Christmas Star Competition! And you know good and well it's been a tradition since you and I were in school here.
Well, I always thought it was kind of stupid myself. So all these people need is another Christmas something or other to go to. This time of the year drives me crazy.
I seem to remember when you were in the pageant. You took home the title of Christmas Star in 1983, and it didn't seem to bother you back then.
Yeah, I remember how everyone was shocked that you won the competition, but of course, I told them I thought you deserved to win. Ha, 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 ha.
Now, Miss Leto, you've been gone meddling in my own past, my own biography, and I don't appreciate that very much. I guess I'll just go and see what Principal Poinsettia has to say about all this. And I'm sure she'll agree with me that the academics need to come before some crazy Christmas play. I'll be back.
It's a competition!
What's up with these costumes you got us wearing in the show? I mean, I don't mean to sound cold, but wearing something like this just ain't how I roll.
These colors and fabrics are just not gonna work for me on camera. I need something a little bit more form-fitting, and I'd like to know which designer are we using.
No, we're not on camera, dear. This is a middle school talent show. I just thought it would be cute for you all to dress up as the three wise men, since you are the three wise judges.
But I am like so not a man.
Yeah, you ain't wise neither. I guess I can at least try on your clothes.
Oh, that's so great! Oh, thank you so much! While you run through the song, I'll get the headdresses!
Headdresses?
Like, I so cannot wear anything on my head. My extensions will get pulled out. And my hairdresser would just have a fit.
Yo, yo, Mr. Music, would you please play? Come on, choir, make my day.
Actually, I go by Nanette Noel now. I'm a French descent. And my brother Dan said he was gonna be here, but
I'm here.
Oh, there he is.
Dan! I just got home from college, some of us gotta get educated, you know.
This is my brother Dannenbaum.
That's Daniel, Navidad to you, Tan, Miss Spanish.
It's good to see you all again.
We're here to get your stage all set up for the big show tomorrow night. Me and Dan are just plumb tickled you kept and called us to come here and take care of your decorations again this year.
Oh, well, I can always count on the Tannenbaum's tree farm. Home to get me through for the competition.
You got that right. Are you ready to get it started? Now, Dan, here sure comes with some humdinger ideas here. Colored blinking lights everywhere, different scenes, Christmas all over the stage, and a piano systems, Christmas pelicans. Line up right here.
Oh, now Dan, stop it. You're embarrassing me.
I'm just telling the truth. This girl's a mega talent when it comes to high-class Christmas decorations. You ought to see our front yard. Why, people come from miles around to see it.
Well, when you got it, you got it. I can't help it.
All right, you two, simmer down now. We got a lot of work to do. What's your trouble?
One of our judges hasn't made it yet. There's a mix-up to who has permission to use this here auditorium. And we haven't even run through all the acts. I don't even know if we have acts to do a show.
Well, never fear. The bombs are here. To save the day. You know, we don't like to brag, but y'all remember we won the Christmas Star competition back in 1979 with that beautiful little ditty my sister here composed.
Oh, Dan.
You what? They won? Oh, yeah, of course you did. Weren't you the only one in the competition that year? Don't make me come over there, Artie. Don't be jealous. You know, we still practice all the time, so we can do it tomorrow night. We fill a little bit of time. What you say?
Yeah, sure. I do remember the year you won, but I'm not sure.
Now, Dan, Miss Latoe may not want us running in on her Christmas show. We had our moment in the sun, and now it's time to let us make room for others to shine.
We're not trying to horn in. We're just trying to help her find out. She needs us, Tan.
I brought the costumes.
Come on, Tan. You know you want to.
All right. Mistletoe, we'll put on our show clothes and do our song. But if you don't like it, you just say the word, and we'll forget the whole thing.
Hot diggity. Let's go.
Yeah. Oh, sure. Why not?
Yo, like it's starting to grow on me. Let's make a good album cover for my Christmas CD.
It's to die.
Mistletoe, about that judge's position.
Listen, Principal Poinsett is at some Christmas luncheon or something. She won't be back for a while. What in the world? See, this is exactly what I'm talking about. If I were a judge in this show, I'd do away with all this foolishness.
Funny you should mention that! I have an idea so we can both get what we want. You be a judge for the competition, and then your students can do their test in the back or whatever, and we'll go on and, you know, you'd be the perfect judge. You were a former winner of the competition.
Oh, yeah. Just how far did you skip those watermelon seeds? I can't remember, but it was quite impressive.
No. You've lost your mind, Miss Latoe. Do you think I'm ever going to be a part of it?
Please, 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 please.
I'm going to be judging is the distance between that door and me to get me out of here.
Yo, yo, come on, dog. Don't leave us hanging. All you got to do is sit and listen to some singing.
When we were kids, you loved Christmas more than anyone I knew. That's why you were in the competition. I remember how hard you worked. Oh, to get here, and you even wrote the song you sang. Maybe you could whip up another one and do it for us tomorrow night. Come on, come on, when you sing.
I know, I used to get all into this Christmas craziness like the rest of you, but things have changed. I've changed, and I'm a lot happier now.
You are?
I am, yes, you heard me right. And Miss Littell, if you remember things so clearly, then you'll also ought to remember what else happened that night. It was horrible. At least I woke up and realized that all this Christmas stuff is for the bugs.
Don't you mean birds?
No, you heard me. It's for the bugs, and you all want a song? Well, I've got a song for you. Hit it, boys. Well, I used to love Christmas more than anything. I used to love to hear the jingle bells ring-a-ling. I used to go to Christmas parties and play silly games. I bought everybody presents, never want to draw names. I got bit by the bah humbug.
Don't let him get you. Like a mosquito?
If you let the humbug get the best of you, you might get bit by the bah humbug too. I used to go caroling in my neighborhood. I used to eat fruit cake and pretend it was good. Decorate everything in red and green. I used to ring a bell for the Salvation Army. It was such a shock to all of my friends when I said, you've had enough of this Christmas nonsense.
Get a prize, Swatter.
Don't even bother if you let the hubbub get the best of you. You might get bit by the bar. We just need to stop having so much fun.
The mission is to spread the word to everyone.
Stop making Christmas such a celebration. The bar, get you in motion. Get your calamine lotion. If you hub up, get the best of you. You might get bit by the bar, humbug too. We can learn a thing or two from old Ebenezer Scrooge. If you let the hub up, get the best of you. Get bit by the bar humbug too. Oh, bar humbug. I'm gonna go see if Christmas Woodson is back yet.
He may hate Christmas, y'all, but I love the song, dog. I say he's in, dog.
And his outfit was to die for. I agree with Spike. He is great.
Hey, what thing was he talking about, you know, that happened with you guys in the competition?
Well, the night he won, he was so proud. Oh, especially of his trophy. He wasn't very popular at school, and, well, he couldn't find it. Him. Oh, his family had been through some
down with all those rhymes. Y'all can rap with me anytime.
I thought it was so totally moving. And your outfits are to die.
Oh, well, thanks, girls. See you tomorrow night.
Okay.
Christmas season. It also promotes physical fitness. And by the way, you seem to like that figgy pudding. It might be a real blessing for you this holiday season. You know, it's amazing how many topics that girl can cover in just one song. Come on, you guys, let's do it!
December's here, but do not fear, we can help you hold on to your Christmas cheer. As you trim your tree and you go shopping, then try not to lose your sanity. When you fight the crowds and you want to shout, here's a little secret that'll help you out.
I got this from Pastor Jim.
time you decide to sit and use us in the show, we'll be rocking and on ready and setting on go. Now we need to change and get to work.
Okay, everyone. Let's take a second.
Miss Latone, just wanted to let you know the principal points out it has found us another room to take the test. So the auditorium is yours.
Oh, that's great! Oh, thanks for letting me know.
Well, listen, I'm sorry I didn't mean to get so bent out of shape about that whole thing before, but this Christmas business just really gets under my skin.
Oh, I understand, Chris. Don't worry about the judging thing. I'll find someone I have complete faith that everything will work out.
You always seemed to have a lot of faith in things, didn't you?
Well, I've got faith in the Lord. Faith that he has a plan for me. And for everything. Even Tinsel Washington not making it here tonight. And I have faith that he has a plan for you too, Chris.
You know, I used to believe that, but I just don't. I don't anymore. Maybe I just don't have the faith that it takes to be a real Christian.
Well, to me, faith means completely depending on the Lord, being confident that he is walking with us through everything we go through, good or bad. And he builds our faith through all these things, whether we see it or not.
You know, I can remember when I was little, I used to read the Bible and read those stories about people in the Bible, and they were just different. Those were special people.
You're special to the Lord too, Chris. I know a lot of things have happened to you in your life that made you feel that you're not special, but let that go. Jesus loves you. That alone makes you special. Mary, Joseph, the shepherds, the wise men, and so other characters were people that let the Lord use them to tell his story. We can let him use us too in our lives if we keep telling the story of Jesus today.
I just could never be like any of them. I couldn't have done what they did.
You're not supposed to. You're supposed to do what God made you to do. And that takes courage. And he'll even give that to you too.
Thank you.
We found these boxes of decorations in the back closet. They look pretty old. You might want to go through them and see what you want to keep, and we'll just throw the rest of them away. Kids just stole it because they didn't like me to play a prank on me, but it must not have been that at all. It's been right here the whole time for all these years.
I think the Lord is trying to get your attention, Chris. Don't waste any more time being angry. Don't worry about things that have happened in the past. Just remember who you are and who you were made to be. Jesus wants you to remember all the times you were really close to him. The time when you were excited about him and his love, and even about Christmas.
I do remember. I do.
He used a stone. He used a star to lead you and seek him again. Does that story sound a little familiar? Like I said, there's a plan for everything. Well, I need to go to the office and check on Tinsel's flight. Would you mind reading the Christmas passage for me? It's been a tradition here for the past few years, and it's a great way to remind the students what the real star of Christmas is.
This is Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who's been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests, teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written: You, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go, make a careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they heard from the king, they went on their way. The star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother, Mary, and they bowed down and they worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, incense, and of myrrh. Having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned back to their country by another route.
In the air, there's a star in the sky.
story. The one who uses it as one of my seeds, and it's messing everything up. I keep telling them that it's not what that verse in Silent Night says.
She's right.
Well, it looks like Tinsel won't be here after all. He's not going to make it, so we'll have to deal with two judges.
Well, Miss Latoa, do you think that maybe that third wise man costume would fit me?
Oh, really, Coach? Yes, of course.
I may be a little rusty, but I should be able to tell the difference between real talent and the artificial kind.
Hey, did somebody call me? Do you need me to do a special number too? I could do one of the most requested Christmas songs. Hey, check this out. Artificial tree, that's me. Hey, why does everyone just envy me? Hey, how's the punch? It's obvious because you see, I've never won the Christmas Star Trophy. Hey, thanks!
Yo, Mr. Artie, you rhyme with such authority.
That was so beautiful. What a passionate performance. And your outfit
is to die for.
Yo, Coach, let's go check out that costume and maybe you can teach me that cool humbug tune.
Well, hey, Mr. Sweet Tea, honey, maybe I can teach you our hustle bustle too. Yeah, we can make it a quartet and we can go on tour with ya.
I'm so excited. It's gonna be great.
Mr. Sweet Tea, morning.
Challenge for Jan and I, and I just have to say Jan is just wonderful. She just rolls with it. She said the dress rehearsal is going to be, you know, last Sunday, and I'm like, I'm gonna be in Texas. And one of the main characters and her daughter, they were in Cleveland, and somehow we just all brought it all together and pulled it off, and it was really wonderful. So I had a talk with the children. We made Miss Jan leave the room, and I asked them if they would do a task or a little chore for their parents or someone so we could collect some money to get a thank you gift. And some of them wrote some letters to her, and maybe some of you still have that to do, and you can give that to her when you have it. So by shaking your head, do you remember what gift we decided on? Okay, so on the count of three, we're gonna tell everybody in the audience Miss Jan's favorite animal. One, two, three. And by the way, I call her Janny Goat. And I know I really enjoyed it, and I know everybody did too, and I think the children were like, whoa, what are these adults doing? So one more round of applause. Let's bow, or you can curtsy if you'd like. One, two, three. And you're welcome to keep the stoles and the costumes. My husband does not want them in our basement.
All right, you can have a seat if you would like, or sit here if you would like. It doesn't matter. I just want to close the service tonight. One, by thanking you so much for coming, for taking time out tonight, and coming to listen to what the children have been working on since October. So they put in a lot of hours trying to learn these songs for you. But they've also been doing something else, I think. And I think by you being here tonight, that was their wish, that you got to hear the meaning behind the story tonight. Our coach, in one of his lines, says, "Lord, I do want to be close to you again. Help me, show me how." And I think these children love Jesus so much and have him in their hearts that they want you to have that as well. And so I would like to let you know that if you're at a place where you haven't found your Christmas star yet, that we really, the children and I, do not want you leaving here tonight without having Jesus in your heart. So we are opening up the prayer room to my right, and we're going to have some pastors and elders back there. If you would like to give your heart to Jesus tonight, we would welcome you and wish that for you. Or if you're not ready for that tonight but you have questions, head back to the prayer room and someone will meet you back there to talk with you about that. So let me close this in prayer and you're dismissed. Father God, we thank you so much for a joyous evening, for the gift of song and laughter, for music, for just all the pieces and parts that we can put together here on earth to praise your name and bring glory to you. Thank you that you are our Christmas star, that you're the reason for this time of year. Pray for safety on the roads as we all leave from here. And I pray that we always can do our best to serve you well. All this we ask in thy name. Amen. Dismissed.